Have you ever had a coworker do something that you thought was bizarre or strange?
Yes.
Share, please.
No, thank you.
You don't want to?
TikTok in the office.
She was into horses. She would compare childcare to her horse care.
Two of these coworkers actually physically got into a brawl.
Everyone's perfect, but they might be watching.
Yeah. That's a very smart answer, very smart. Before the show, Charles and I always go out on the street and sort of accost people and say, come talk to us, and guess what they do? Everybody's got a crazy story about their strange colleague or their very difficult boss. Our next guest is a perfect person, we think, to tackle those tricky work situations. You know a tricky work situation? Have you ever had a tricky work situation?
Gayle, we're not going to last much longer.
Okay.
So Gayle...
Wait, we have to say who she is. Renowned writer, culture commentator, and Professor Roxane Gay is here. We're so glad you're here, Professor Gay.
Oh, thank you so much for having me. It's
so
great.
I took Gayle to...
May I start?
No. I took Gayle to dinner last week.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, we were at the All-Star game.
Mm-hmm.
I always take people out who I like and want to work. They work so hard, they get a break. And she shows up. She says, oh, you got 10 friends with you. She wasn't paying the bill. Is that all right?
No, Roxane, before you answer that, say you land in Indiana, for instance, for the All-Star game.
Mm-hmm.
You text your friend and say, hey, want to get together for dinner? Said friend says, yes, 6 o'clock at name the place.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The place that they chose, I didn't think was great because...
It was a chain.
It was a chain restaurant.
Gayle's thinking, a snob.
No, Gayle's not a snob, but...
I didn't name the chain.
Roxane, no, please don't, because it's a good chain. But I'm thinking if you're in a different city, try something that you can't get anywhere else. Okay, fine. So I make the reservations and I call him and say, great, I got us in at 6:30. He said, for how many? I said, two. He goes, two? Well, I have 10 people. 10 people? No one, he didn't tell me that he had 10 people. Don't you think that when I reached out to him, the proper thing to do would have been to say, hey, Gayle, listen, I'm going out to dinner with friends. Would you like to join us? As opposed to, yeah, let's go to dinner. And I'm thinking it's the two of us together. What do you think?
Well, I think when you go into a dinner invitation thinking it's going to be an intimate conversation for two or
I didn't say
maybe even four.
Wait. I didn't say intimate conversation.
Well, not intimate in that way.
I just wanted to get together for dinner.
Yeah, I would be surprised if he was
an
like, yeah, I've got 10 friends.
Well,
What did you say?
I'd be surprised if he said, I have 10 friends. But
and his friends
when you're
are very
all
nice.
In a different city... I wouldn't be surprised that someone said, hey, would you mind if I bring these other 10 friends along?
Just for future reference, Roxane?
Yes, Charles.
Gayle's got good taste.
Oh, really?
I really missed that chain price tag that night.
I bet. Indianapolis surprisingly has some good restaurants.
They do.
She picked the best one.
And I'm not knocking his friends. It's not that. Mm-hmm. But if you just think that it's just going to be the two of you, if he just said, look, I already have dinner plans with my friends. Would you like to join us? I would have said yes.
Mm-hmm.
I would have said yes. It's just that if you think that it's just going to be the two of you and he says, oh, I have 10 people. am I wrong? Am I wrong?
You're not wrong.
Okay.
You're not wrong. That's a difficult one where you, yeah, okay. You're not wrong.
Are you done now?
Yes, I am.
You want to take the next question?
No, proceed. You go ahead.
So what if you have, this is a work question.
Yeah.
Yes.
If you have a disagreement with a coworker and they start giving you the silent treatment, how do you handle that?
Personally, I respond in kind. If you give me the silent treatment, I'm going to pretend you don't exist.
Really?
Really. Because life is short and...
Roxane.
I know.
You don't... Roxane.
That's it. I have nothing to say to you. Now, of course...
See, welcome to my world. See, Gayle disagrees with you now because you disagree with her. But when you was gassing her up last segment, she was like, I love you, Roxane.
Roxane is a genius.
Right.
Go on.
So if somebody gives you the silent treatment... You give it back. You don't try to work this out?
Well, first I'll try to work it out. But if it has gotten to the point of silent treatment, I assume that the person in question has already tried to mediate, has gone to a manager, has suggested, hey, can we have a conversation about this?
All right.
People who go to the silent treatment level have decided that there's no resolution to be had here and you are dead to me.
Okay.
And I will just meet like with like and never use my voice again and... Never.
I hear, too, that you get a lot... Your column is very famous, we should say. I hear that you get a lot of questions from people talking about smelly coworkers.
Yes, absolutely.
This is a thing? This is a thing.
This is a thing. I mean, I'm sure you guys have dealt with that.
I have had a smelly coworker.
Oh, that's right, especially on the court.
Yeah. Off the court, too.
Is it because they're athletes or the locker room or no, something different?
Depending on what country you're from, some guys did not take showers or use deodorant. But I think in some countries, I apologize if I'm wrong, it's a cultural thing.
Okay. But what about in an office? Because most of us aren't.
In an office, you have to say something. It's so uncomfortable.
You have to say
though.
Something to the coworker?
Well, as gently as possible. But I mean, do you want to spend the rest of your life smelling your stinky
friend? I don't know a gently way
to
say that.
I mean, it's just like, excuse me, but are you dealing with something? Do you have a hormonal issue? Is the water not working at your home? What's going on?
No, what about, okay, I guess I got a serious question for you.
Yes.
What if you, see, this is like my pet peeve. Like, I brush my teeth a lot. I'm always pumping in mints and everything. Mm-hmm. How do you have, if you got a friend with bad breath, that's like my pet peeve. Because people walk to me all the time. The last thing I'm out with them and said to me, that Charles Barkley got bad breath. So I'm always spraying, I'm always carrying mints. How do you handle that?
Again, you have to be really delicate. It's such a challenging thing to tell someone, like, something about your very physical being is off. But do you really want someone with halitosis all up in your face all day? And the answer is no. And so in something like that, I would just be like, hey, by the way, I have these extra Altoids. Would you like them?
Ashley, you can never turn down mints. Because anytime people offer you mints, that's a...
You should take it?
That's a hint.
It is always a hint.
Is it always a hint?
Or, you know,
I turn down mints all the time. Because I'm thinking I don't want to be chomping on something. So is that a hint?
Yeah, I think it is. I really do. I think it is.
Roxane, we're so glad you're here.
I'm so glad to be here.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.